The railway has a small workshop next to the servicing area. These days it needs to take in outside work to earn extra money. It does all its own maintenance too. With just two locos, it's vital to keep them in good repair. This coal isn't for the railway, it's needed to fire the bricks. The coal the railway does use is of quite poor quality. Clearing out the clinker is a regular task all day. But even the clinker itself does have its uses. And it's off up the line again. This time we're taking a trip with number 207. Stop.
Thank you.
This is the pig farm, seen in part one. This onboard sequence was shot in late 2008, by which time some changes in operation had occurred compared to part one of the film. Head shunt has been extended, and although the old conveyor belt is still there, the clay is now loaded by earth movers. With a loaded train, the brakes on six of the wagons at the back have to be screwed down. Brakes still need constant attention. Thank you.
Thank you.
a new level crossing has been installed, and the loco diverges earlier than before. Quick check round the engine, and more clinker to be disposed of to stop it clogging up the fire. After all that action, it's time for lunch. The bricks are cooked. Now they'll be taken out and stacked, ready for storage or sale. Supplies of clay are running out. In any case, modern China prefers concrete to brick, so the future of the brickworks and its railway hangs in the balance. Xingyang as a town is a pretty soulless place. Even the temple next to the line is kept locked and bolted. But as for the cave houses, some at least have found a new use.